Hi. So this is my response to the Chapter 1 challenge. What type of teacher are you and who do you want to be? So the first answer to the question, what type of teacher am I? I believe that I'm a type of teacher who relates to students, who attempts to relate to students, and who attempts to answer their questions efficiently and effectively in class. I use pre-printed notes for the students, and I tell them what I'm writing down in the notes. I've learned it many times. I've been doing this 15 years. So if I'm writing it down again, it's important, because I wouldn't bother writing it down if they shouldn't write it. And that's the kind of teacher I am. I'll walk around. I'll write something down in my notebook. I'll walk around, and I'll see if they've written it down. And I'll ask them, you know, how's your day going? If I see they haven't written it down, I'll say, hey, you know, how's your day going? What's going on? Is there something you want to talk about with me or another adult? Or is there something I can help you with? Ultimately, I'm the type of teacher who believes that students' education is up to them. It's in their power. And it can be empowering to them as a student. So if they decide not to do the notes, if they decide not to learn, ultimately I do allow that. I talk to their parents. I talk to the support here at school, and I make my best effort to get them to learn something from this classroom, whether it be math related or whether it be something else. I've had students in the past who don't necessarily learn as much related to math in this class as they do to other things. For example, I had a student named John who's special ed, and he learned more about how to interact with other students than he did about math, because he was already really good at what we were doing in class, mathematically speaking, but he wasn't good at all interacting with other students. He was somewhat autistic, and he didn't understand how to speak to other people, what to say and what to do. So the second part of that question is, who do you want to be? So I want to be the teacher that a student can trust coming to and talking about something that's going on in their life, and that they can trust that I will help them to the best of my ability, and that I will advocate for them in front of the administration and as well as their parents in terms of what is in their best interest for the future. I don't want to be the student that's just always going to be on their side, but I want to be the teacher who is on the side of their future, in their best interest for the future. And I also want to be the teacher that they can trust. They can trust to know the answer to their question, and that they can rely on to give them the right answer every time. So yeah, that's also why I don't answer questions that I don't fully understand. So if they'll ask me something about the district policy or a school policy that I don't fully understand, I'll refer them to our administration, and then I'll ask the administration with them. Sometimes I'll go up with them and I'll ask them, you know, what's the policy here? What are we supposed to do? Anyways, so those are my answers to those two questions. Thanks.